Hello fellow tankers, bonjour amis tankistes. In this video, I will present you a gameplay on the domination version of the German map from the other side of my first video. So let me remind you that on this map, essentially C is irrelevant. You need just a little bit of presence close to C, essentially to avoid the enemy ultimately to push toward your spawn, but essentially you don't need to cap C and you don't need to have too many tanks there. This cap is irrelevant and the fight is on A and B, the two connected caps. And here the red side has an advantage because they can push up to this very good position, which will allow to pin the red tanks here. And which will allow you also to shoot at B. Let me also mention this excellent camping spot from the right side, which provide another shooting angle toward B. So definitely B is easier to attack from the right side. Let me also mention again that to cap A, you have really first to clean this area, and again the red side has an advantage. And my advice from the green side is that if you don't see red tanks in this area, if the red tanks are a bit too passive, that you try to push immediately toward this rock, which will allow you first to some of your allies to cap A. But it will really prevent the red tanks to come in this area, and in particular to this area, which is extremely extremely powerful. So let me start the gameplay. So I'm very often starting with B from this side. From the other side, very often I'm going between A and B to this very powerful position that I mentioned. Sometimes I also go go to B, but from this side very often I'm trying to get B, especially before red tanks come to this dangerous area. So very often I'm going to B and then I'm coming down essentially to eliminate the red tanks which should be here. So here this red tank is still focused in fighting the green tanks, but he could actually already start shooting at B. So here I realize I completely forgot that, but the fact that the tiger is a bit too tall, and unfortunately on this near this temple you have these planks, wooden planks here, which are impenetrable, and obviously which offer you some protections, but which also will stop many of your shots. And as you can see, the red tanks have pushed nicely in the area, very effective area that I mentioned, and we are able to cap A. So really you saw me turn, I was considering to leaving the cap simply because that cap is not very easily to fight on with a very tall tank. And I'm killing the last tank on the cap, so I finally decide to cap it. But my intention now is actually to go back and essentially try to eliminate tanks between A and B. So there are quite a lot of enemies, so unfortunately I cannot go really in the lower ground. I'm completely missing my my first shot. I'm so excited to see so many tanks which are not looking at me. But unfortunately, I should have gone a bit low in the lower grounds, and I'm shot by a camper on the hills. So at this point, I'm considering coming back to this area between A and B, but finally I decided to go back to B because we are losing B, and again despite the fact that I'm in a Tiger, I will try to do my best. But as you can see on the map, our tanks near between A and B are a bit too passive. They should really try to push and kill the red tanks in this area. And we have lost a B. Get my revenge against this AS1 who killed me. And I'm actually shot by the Panther who was on B but who died. So I'm capping B. But my intention is to come back between A and B to really prevent red tanks to come back. So here the mistake of the red tanks is to have gone toward A without trying again to recontrol the area where they were. The mistake also of the red tanks is to have essentially committed suicide. They were in very good positions where they were pinning our green tanks behind the hills, and instead of pushing, they should have actually covered the B from this position. And essentially you had a very good example of a team which was winning and which collectively committed suicide. So again, going to A without controlling this area between A and B is a suicide. So so really, if you see that the enemy is strong in this area, just don't go to A and try to control again this this area. So now I'm pushing a bit to eliminate the few tanks which have still a view over the hill, and you see that the enemy is actually pushing B quite aggressively and is now capturing C. But again, C is essentially irrelevant. Very often you will find on this battle that the winning side wins with A and B, the two connected caps, and essentially these two caps are very easily defended and attacked from by the same players, whether C is very isolated, and essentially C has no impact on the battle. So the enemy is recapturing B, and I'm coming essentially from behind. That's actually a very effective move. Let me mention that staying on the hill on my right here is a very effective move for the green side in RB. You will surprise a lot of enemies. Obviously you have to do that with a pretty mobile tank, but being here in this area here where you are actually very very nicely covered is extremely powerful in RB. So here there is a very bad bombing by one of my allies, and I had to stop and I slided. I was aware of this T-34, but the fact that I had to stop because of the bombs left me in his open view. That's actually the guy who killed me in the beginning with the IS-1, and that I killed now twice. I have to confess that an eye for an eye is my favorite reward in the game. And at this point the battle is essentially finished. As you can see, we are capping C again, but essentially that was absolutely not necessary. The battle was won in A and B, as always on this map. So at this point the battle is finished. This comet will escape and survive the game. And I thank you for watching, and I really invite you to also watch my main tutorial on this map, where I really detailed the most important areas, but that we have seen here, and where I again insist on the fact that fighting between A and B and on B is the most important thing to do on this map. And when you control this area between A and B, you can ultimately cap A, but obviously not before doing that. So see you on the battlefield, à bientôt sur le champ de bataille.